If, when they've acknowledged, yes, I do sense some hesitation, resistance, we now move to the second question. And the second question is?
What do you believe would happen if you were to connect to your emotion? Okay, essentially, what do you believe would happen if you were to do the opposite of what you're doing? Okay, so if what they're doing, if the solution is blocking out emotion, what do you believe would happen if you were to connect with your emotion?
Now, sometimes we add a little addendum to that question to clarify. What do you believe would happen if you did choose to connect your emotion that's causing you to hesitate or to resist? We'll add that little tail to the end of it for the, to help to
explain,
teach the
concept.
Person the purpose of the question. So what do you believe would happen if you let your anger go that causes you to resist or hesitate letting your anger go?
Because a lot of times, if again, it all comes down to their understanding of the process. So if you have somebody who is not familiar with how this works, and you ask them, what do you believe would happen if you were to, let's say, dealing with anger again, what do you believe would happen if you were to let your anger go? Well, if they don't understand what I'm asking
right.
and why I'm asking, let's say they respond with, oh, that'd be great. It would just be gone. I wouldn't have to deal with it. I could move on with my life. It would be so freeing. Well, you see how, yes, obviously that's true. But why would that cause you to resist or hesitate letting it go?
Right.
If you honestly believed that, why would you hang on to it?
Right.
Right? So granted, yes, they understand that truth. They believe that if I were to let this go, that would be so much better. In the same way that, okay, Dad, what do you believe would happen if you were to jump? Oh, that'd be great. I have so much fun. I'd be able to enjoy it like you guys. So why aren't you doing it? You see how you're not answering the question that I'm asking. Okay, you're looking in a different direction. You're giving me what is the obvious intellectual, logical truth. Yes, of course, jumping off a cliff is more fun than standing there scared. But that thought is not why you're stuck. Okay? And so we just bring some clarification as to what we're actually asking at that point.
So the intent of the question is?
What this question accomplishes, in the same way that the first question, what it accomplishes is it exposes the fact that a solution is present. Okay, so if I am resisting or hesitating connecting to my emotion, then that means I'm engaged in a solution behavior. That's what the first one tells me, that I got something that I need to address. The second question, what do you believe would happen if you were to do the opposite of your behavior? What that does is exposes the perceived problem. You see how this question is asking about the consequences. What would happen if you stopped doing the solution? What would happen if you put your anger down? What would happen if you connect to your emotion? What would happen if you did remember? What would happen if you let go of your anger? Well, here's the consequence. Here's the problem that I'm trying to solve with my solution. Okay? So that's what the second question does. It exposes the problem or the perceived problem that I'm trying to resolve with the solution.